In this video, we will learn about the Transform API, which is yet another useful and important API. All right, let's open the transform underscore object underscore pose script in the hrwros underscore week 5 package to proceed. And again, we see the relevant imports here, which also includes the tf2 underscore ros module, like we just saw also with the robot squabbler script. Note also that we have to import the tf2 geometry messages module to be able to use the transform API of tf. Lastly, we import the geometry messages module, and we will soon see why. Then we create the tf buffer here, also with the default buffer size, and associate the buffer to a tf listener so that the buffer can store tf messages. All right, earlier in this week's videos, we learned about the logical camera, and also that the logical camera publishes the pose of the objects it detects on a ROS topic. And we also learned that the position and orientation information contained in the published pose messages from the logical camera are with the reference frame which is referring to itself. Now, let's find out how to actually have an object in the field of view of our camera or the frustum of the logical camera. So let's switch to our terminal, source our setup files, and start the factory simulation. And once we have the simulation environment up and running, we verify all our robots show up where we expect them. And here we have the logical camera looking over the conveyor belt. Now, let's first move the robot away from the field of view of the camera with the MoveIt commander. So we switch back to the terminal, start a new terminal, source our setup files, and start MoveIt commander as we learned in week 4. Then let's move the robot to R1 home position. We do so like this. And now, in another terminal, we source our setup files again. And we call a service to spawn an object in the field of view of the camera by typing ROS service call spawn object once. Now, if we go back to the simulation in Gazebo, we have our object below the logical camera. Very nice. Now, let's see if the logical camera is publishing the new object information by running the command ROS topic echo hrwros logical camera and search for the object string in the output. And there we have the object name and pose information with reference to the logical camera. So, with this in mind, let's go back to our code again. Since the object pose information is available on a ROS topic, we subscribe to the topic like we do here. And from week 1, we know that whenever we subscribe to a topic, we will process the message we receive on the topic in a subscriber callback function. So, let's see what is being done in the subscriber callback function. Remember, the logical camera detects all objects that intersect with its frustum, and we are interested in only the object we want to pick up. And we learned in an earlier video that if the logical camera detects an unknown object, it just publishes the model name as object. And this was also confirmed by the output of ROS topic echo. All right, now we go to the last section of this code illustration, which is the actual transformation of the object pose to a target reference frame. The API transform can only work with poses that have a timestamp, because timing information is super important in TF. Let's not get into the details and take this as a requirement in the context of this course. The exact details are beyond the scope of this course. So, here we create an object of the post-stamped type, and then we update the header and timestamp information. The logical camera always outputs the pose of an object in its own reference frame, and that frame is called logical underscore camera underscore frame. This is true if we only have one camera, one logical camera. But when we have more, this will change. But we have taken care of that for you in the assignments and also modified download files accordingly. And lastly, we update the pose information like this. Now we are ready to use the transform API. In this example, we will transform the pose of the object from the logical camera reference frame to the world reference frame, and we do so like this. And here we print the transformed pose with rospy.loginfo. And for the sake of comparison, let's also print the pose in the logical camera reference frame. All right then, let's run this script now and see what the transform API does. So, we switch to the terminal and run the script with rosrun hrwros underscore week 5 transform underscore object underscore pose dot py. And here we see the output. The first pose is the pose of the object in the world reference frame, that is the output of the transform API. And the second pose is the pose of the object in the logical camera reference frame. Let's quickly understand the numbers if they actually make sense. So, let's recall the right-hand rule. The world reference frame always has x-axis pointing forward, y-axis to the left, and z-axis upwards. This is in accordance with the right-hand rule. And here, we see all the position coordinates in the world reference frame have positive values. To verify if that's correct, let's go back to the gazebo simulation. Without getting into the exact detail, we know roughly from our URDF model that our world reference frame is about here. So, positive values in the context of right-hand rule means the object is forward, then to the left, and then up. So, that makes sense, isn't it? And we could also just see the pose of the object on the panel here, which confirms what we did is correct. You could similarly verify the coordinates from the logical camera frame. Just remember that the logical camera frame is rotated by 90 degrees about the y-axis. So, that means the x-axis of the logical camera is pointing downwards towards the object. Also, for this course, we will not discuss rotations, and for your assignments, the rotations are also taken care of in the scripts you will download for week 5 assignments. All right then, that concludes the code illustration of the TF API transform.